Hello, my name is Leo, and welcome to another week of Raising Shinji Ikari. As you might have heard in my Raising Grey Anime and Oscar Lady Soyou, for whatever reason, I began speaking in a French accent today. And my French accent has changed quite significantly. It is not really a French accent anymore, but is something quite akin. There is a Flash series that I seem to recall, on newgrounds.com called You Are a Fucking Moron. Does anybody know this one? It starred a red demon-looking gentleman who spoke in an accent quite similar to the one that I'm speaking in now. He also used the same intonations that I am now, like talking about one particular thing, and then talking about another thing, using those particular inflections in his voice. He always ended his rant talking about a particular group or party or person that was perhaps not sound of mind or doing something stupid, and ending it by saying, blank, you are a fucking moron. It's quite interesting. I learned all about Scientology from that Flash animation. Gave the whole story about Xenu and the volcano and the Titans and the E-meters and all that stuff. If you pop over to newgrounds.com, look up You Are a Fucking Moron, or the acronym of such, which would be YAFM? Yafum? You might be able to find his videos, which are both informative and funny. In any case, we are now with our good friend here, Shinji Ikari, who, together with our sexy lady, Misato Katsuragi, we will be going through the journey of Evangelion together. So, what did I do this week? Well, I do not remember, so I'm not going to talk about this week, but I am going to talk about today, because it's fresh in my mind. As I mentioned in the Ray Anime project, the Ray Anime Raising project that is, just before recording that video, I had recently come home from going to a Japanese restaurant. This is a family restaurant where they serve Western-style cuisine at a low price. Although not as low as could be, I rarely go there because I have no money. But the mother-in-law was shouting me, so of course, I think I'm going to turn down a free meal. You are a fucking moron. Ooh, that worked pretty well. I did not realize that that was going to happen. Anyway, I ate a quote-unquote Californian-style hamburger steak. There is such a thing. I do believe there is not. Japanese concept of what an American-style burger leaves a lot to be desired. Nevertheless, it was quite a nice hamburger steak. It's quite an interesting Swiss cheese sauce. Swiss cheese mustard sauce topping thing. Whatever, it also came with tortilla chips. Cause that's California, right? Anyway, I guess California is close to Mexico. Kind of. Never mind. Anyway, it was quite enjoyable. I also had a chocolate cake, and I got the drink bar, which lets you drink as much soda as you want. So I drank all the soda I could. I proceeded to pee many times afterwards. Yay. Anywho, there was a point to the story. I said I forgot what it was. You know, that was it. That was my week. See you next week, everyone. Okay. Anyway. Shinji, how are you?
Okay.
Okay, shut up. What is your status, Shinji? How is your sync ratio? It goes up by 12 points every time? So... 2 more turns? 84, 90... Yeah, let's do 2 more turns and then a bunch of... study, I guess. Study at the lighthouse for the week, because that, keeps our sexuality low. Ah, yes, I do believe. I remember that. Let's finish, though. I have things I want to talk about. I.e. video games that I've been playing and have almost completed. Almost, but not quite. But I will talk about that in quite a moment. First, I want to do... Sync ratio! Something that isn't study. Or maybe I'll just do a whole bunch of study. I would actually like to do the one that makes him listen to Misato more. Which is the one that makes him listen to Misato. This one, perhaps? I really don't know. Sure. Let's do that. Let's do that and check the results. Okay. I do study for the rest of the week. Okay, fair enough. Anyway, of the games, I have almost completed Persona 3. I was supposed to be playing that game day by day. And that game finished on January 31st. Here we are. Almost in March. I have not yet finished the game. Although, after you defeat the final boss at the end of the 31st of January, which I did, it then time skips all the way to March 3rd, so I guess I'm not late after all. As long as I finish in the next few days. But I'm just about there. I'm basically just finishing the game. Persona 3 is a good game. I look forward to playing Persona 4. Which, yes, I will be doing it on the channel. I will be taking a little trip before we start that game, but I should be back in time to begin the playthrough. That'd be fun. Yes, I am taking a small trip at the end of March, beginning on the 27th of March, I believe. I'll be doing a little bit of a tour, going to some places, going to Osaka, going to Kyoto, perhaps going to Nara, going to Hiroshima. So anywhere else that I'm going to go? I'm not going to go to Tokyo this particular time. My parents actually are coming to Japan, so I'm going to be meeting them in Osaka and then driving them around Japan as a little tour guide. That'd be fun. I hope. It'd be fun. If it's not fun, would be quite disagreeable. I'll have to make sure that I record this in case it needs to go up on Sunday before. Might do that on Saturday instead of our regularly scheduled Sunday recordings. And then schedule stuff to go up automatically so that I don't actually need to do it. Though, be forewarned, I do usually add them to their relevant playlists. If you rely on said playlists, be aware that at least until I come back on the 3rd of April, the videos that are being released will not be going into the allotted playlists. Apologies for that, but you'll just have to deal. Anyway, that's episode 3. Cool game. There's been a lot of talk about waifus, particularly waifus in Persona 4, which I look forward to deciding my waifu. It's probably going to be Chie. She seems like the kind of girl that I would like, though I don't want to completely discredit the other girls. We'll see what happens. But as far as Persona 3, I don't know if there's really a lot of groundswell among waifu talk with Persona 3, but I don't know if waifus also include, like, non-playable characters. Or, I mean, characters that aren't in your immediate party. I know episode 4, Nanako is also included in this discussion. Despite the fact that that's kind of gross. The reason why I'm saying this is because episode 3, the first girl that I romanced her name was Chihiro, I believe. Which is interesting that Chihiro, for those of you who have played P3, her design is actually what Fuka's design was originally going to be before they changed Fuka to what she became, which wasn't really that interesting, to be honest. And then they took that design that they were going to use for Fuka and turned her into Chihiro. Chihiro is... she's awesome. I like her very much. She's my waifu. The waifu needs to be someone in the party, or one of the main characters. Then I shall choose Mitsuru, because she is unbelievably awesome. I still choose Chihiro over her, because Chihiro is a very modest and very down-to-earth kind of girl. The one downside that I don't particularly like about Mitsuru is that she's kind of a rich knob. But at least when you do her S-Link, she kind of stops being a rich knob. And I mean, in the main story, she stops being a rich knob as well. But yeah, she's still got that sort of stigma. There've been talks about that where you can't take Mitsuru because Mitsuru is Akihiko's girl. Well, I disagree with that. Akihiko really never made any real pass at her. So I think it's a bad game, despite the fact that at least Akihiko and Mitsuru are in the same grade and I'm like a grade lower than her. Never mind. As for the other main characters, Fuka is okay, but I'm not really romantically interested in her. Ikari, she's the girl next door, but I don't really care. Is there another girl? Oh, Aegis! At the end of the game, I began doing Aegis's S-Link. And although I often did, when I was younger, in my younger days, fantasize about the perfect ideal woman in a female robot form. Aegis herself doesn't really do it for me. Could be the hair. Well, it could be a lot of things, but not really. I didn't really like her. But I didn't actually complete her S-Link, unfortunately. But her S-Link story was quite nice. I quite enjoyed it. As far as S-Link stories are concerned, possibly my favorite S-Link would have to be... I was going to say the online MMO one with Maya, especially if you find out who Maya is. Although I had my suspicions about who Maya was. But it's quite funny. I had a good old chuckle when I found out that one. I did. Anyway. But my favorite S-Link would probably be... I believe his name was... No, I forgot his name. It started with A. He is the boy that sits... He's the dying boy that sits at the shrine with a... black and white stripy referee shirt, even though he's not a referee. I really liked his story. It was quite depressing, but quite moving. And the story about the pink alligator was also quite interesting. Who else was really good? Let's talk about the people that I fully S-ranked. S-ranked? No. I maxed out their social link. I maxed out Maiko, the girl at the shrine, did her fairly early. I maxed out, of course, the dying man at the shrine. I maxed out Chihiro, of course, who is, I think she is, I forgot what arcana she is, but she is the treasurer of the student council. I maxed out, what's that dude? The dude from your class. Kenji? the guy that was dating one of the teachers, he's an okay guy, I guess. Also, the sports dude, who is the social link when you go to join a sports club. I did not... Oh, wait, let's talk about ones that I fully maxed out. The old couple at the bookstore. Mitsuru. Who else? The S-Ranks. Oh, the nighttime ones. The old monk. As well as, Takana. The skeezy dude who, like, jibs everyone. Oh, of course, Maya on the MMO. And, well, there is the death run and the one for, the Nixon Annihilation team, but I believe that happens automatically anyway, so that's not really something that you can do. So I got a lot of the way through Yukari's, Fuka's, maybe, Fuka was maybe halfway. I wasn't really progressing them because I didn't want to get romantically involved with them. The Fuka seemed like she couldn't get romantically involved, although that could have just been something that I was doing. Never really had any instances of girls getting jealous of other girls, but then again, I didn't really move on to another girl until I had finished, like, maxing out the link with the first girl. I barely touched the French exchange student. Quite ironic, considering that I am doing the French accent today. Wasn't really interested in his aesthetic at all. I didn't do much of the rival guy. I did a decent amount of, I think her name was Yuko, the girl who is like the manager of the sports club that you go to. I barely touched... Yeah, I really barely touched the leader of the student council. That douchebag who was looking for someone who was smoking. I think I did like two ranks of him. And then I never saw him again. Not that I really wanted to, but, you know, whatever. I seem to have missed a couple of S-Lanks, like, completely. I believe that there was another gentleman in the nightclub who looked awfully a lot like Vincent from Catherine. I don't remember the original conversation I had with him, but I must have chosen a wrong choice, because instead of, like, getting the ability to talk to him, he just kept saying, "I really unloaded on you, I'm sorry, I feel like shit, see you later, bye," every time I talk to him. But I'm pretty sure he's an S-Link because he has a caricature, I mean, a profile, like a picture for him. Anyway, that's all the S-Links for Persona 3. I'm gonna now proceed with the week of Shinji Ikari. Yes, I'm happy. Is something going to happen this week? We could possibly be faced with an angel attack. Which angel? What's the angel after Zerul? Oh yes, the one that rapes Asuka's mind. Oh, speak of the freaking devil. That's what's going to happen. Now I'm going to translate in a French accent. Wait, I really need to drop the French accent in order to do this. I cannot do two things at once. No, you must continue with the French accent. This is vitally important. Okay, fair enough. Oi de nas... another one? Maybe? I guess that's what she said. Yes, Alba, I don't know what you said, but I'm sure it was very important. Yep, there she is. Pattern is blue. It is an angel. It is out of the range of our scanners. Is it going to come here and attack us? Probably. It is out of the range of our rifles. There is nothing we can do unless it comes to us. There is nothing we can do unless it comes out of orbit. We can't go and attack it either. We have no way of launching an Oscar. We have no way of launching an Oscar into outer space. Though I thoroughly assure you that if there was such a way, I would launch her in an instant. Anyway, how about the pilots? The three pilots are ready to go to war. Is that though? I'm going out. You don't know anything about this angel, right? You don't know its attack buttons or anything? Then I shall go by myself and look for myself. Oscar. Do we really want Oscar to go do this? Might be a good idea, but then again, it might not. Never mind. It's good. It's fine. Unit 2 will sortie, and Unit 0 will provide backup. Yay! I get to go out and fight! Misato, what about me? Shinji will stay here. There has been a lock placed on Unit 1. I do not have the authority to unlock it. So there's not much we can do about it. Don't worry about it, Misato. I will take care of everything. Unit 2 will launch. I guess I don't actually... Do I control this? There's twin towers there behind us. They're a little bit wider, but... Why? What is... Ooh, there's a little clipping going on there. Do I control this? Ooh. Unit 2, your head looks rather odd. I don't think your eyes should be that far back. I'm pretty sure they should be here somewhere. Well, never mind. Okay, it would appear as though I do not have any control of this. It's just happening. We're trying to analyze the beam, but it has no properties. It's not a laser. Psychograph of piloted Unit 2 is going off the charts. We need to get her out of there. Impossible! Massacre! How could the angel launch this kind of attack? Asuka! Oh no! Please stop! Don't come in here! Oh, Oscar! Get the fuck out of my brain! The signal graph is... We're losing signal! You need to reverse it! I cannot move in this condition! I have no way, I can't do anything! Our condition is now Y! Whatever that means! Anyway, Unit 2's pilot's life signs are becoming not good! Asuka! Retreat! Asuka! No, Oscar, Misato, I'm going out! No, you will not be going out! Why? Why, father? We cannot allow you to sort it this time, Shinji. It would be most unpleasant if the angel did some kind of attack on Unit 1. Considering the very importance of Unit 1. Anyway, Ray, go to Dogma and get the spear. I understand. Here comes Ray. Oh, hello. Oh, look, it's the lads of Eloginus. This is the only weapon that we have to fight something that's outside of our orbit. Ray, make sure you throw it really, really well. I understand. Targets attacking. Ready? Wait, you're counting down to what exactly? Maya, I believe you're a little bit too late. Ray's already thrown the spear. It's already gone. Look at it. It's gone. Also, there's no moon in the sky. Oh. Isn't the Lens Illusion supposed to end up in the moon after this is done? Never mind, I guess. Do you believe that Arba just said that the angel was defeated, even though there was no visual representation of this? It's kind of sloppy if you ask me. Anyway, Maya, Unit 2 is being recovered. What about Oscar? Pilot is not having a good day. Well, it's not too good, okay? I don't know how else to describe it, Misato. Hurry up and recover Unit 2. Get on with it. How about the Lance Eloginus? It did one of two things. I'm not quite sure because I cannot translate it. It's either orbiting the moon, or it stuck itself in the moon. This changes whether or not you're talking about the movie, End of Evangelion, or the series. Because in the series, it's like orbiting the moon, but then in the End of Evangelion, it's stuck into the moon. Then it comes out to come back down to Earth. I didn't quite understand that, because it was clearly orbiting the moon in the series, and then it stuck in the moon somehow. Never mind. If you have a comment about this, please leave a comment. Because it's one of those perplexing things about Evangelion. Is that the end of this week? I don't know. What day is it? It's freaking Wednesday! Oh my god! You've clearly done nothing, and you also need to talk about Metal Gear Solid. Oh yes, I do. Forgot all about that. So did we end up getting that second sync ratio session? Oh, I believe we might have lost it! Oh well, supposed to do another one next week. It's the first day of the month, so I'm gonna get some money! Yay, money! Money's good. Ray and Shinji study together. And on Saturday morning, I think Ray and Shinji study some more. Or not. Wait. This is Friday. Oh, alright. Oh? Oh. Hang on. I think we have discovered something. Oh, we're having some special cutscene. I do believe that the other characters might have different schedules each week. I thought they had the same schedule every week. I think Shinji's about to have some kind of a thing with Aoi. We don't want this. We want Shinji to get with Karu. I'm not entirely sure what Aoi is talking about, but she's offering to do something for him. I'm kind of tired. No, this is not what we want. No, Shinji, do not be tempted by the temptress of fate. She is bad. Stay away from the women's. You need to be attracted to the cow dick. Oh dear, this is most unpleasant. I have a right mind to never let Shinji study ever again. It's Aoi's bad influence on him. What on earth are they talking about?
So, the perfect teacher is this
me. Don't really know.
But if we
are going on some bullshit about study of humans and how knowledge is life.
Aoi-san?
And she's like, Aoi, what the fuck are you talking about? Is it just me or is there some kind of air siren going on in the background? Is this something that we should be concerned about? She's like, Aoi, please stop touching me. Anyway, you just need to keep doing the good job that you're doing, Shinji. You're a good lad, you are, Shinji. Oh dear! Oh, that is most regrettable! Oh, my whopping 30-point jump in Shinji's sexuality! Oh, that's terrible! Oh no, and we've got another session! Okay. That's very bad. Wait, is she talking to Kaji? No? Who is she talking to? I can't read the Kaji and I wasn't listening to her. Who is she talking to?
Yosh, tsugi ne. Sochi wa dou? Ara so.
I believe he said he was talking to someone on the telephone. It would appear as if Shinji's not too happy about this, though. Why is Shinji so angry? Shinji, you're here, aren't you? Oscar's not... Oh, he's worried about Oscar. Oh, I see. That's right. Nerve personnel are looking for Oscar. And perhaps they found her. Shinji's not angry at Masato, per se. He's just worried about Oscar. This makes sense. I thought for some reason that Shinji was, like, thinking that Masato was part of some kind of nerve conspiracy? Which is, of course, possible. Masato's face seems really long in this picture. Even though it's clearly the same picture we've always looked at. Which looks kind of long. I don't know what to say. Still 60. Soto. In fact, I once made a character. And actually made a manga. And my main character pretty much has the same hair as hairstyle as this. Not intentionally. It just happens that Masato and my character have the same kind of hair. Oh, I'm very sorry, Shinji. I skipped over your lines. Anyway, Masato's like, don't worry, Shinji. There will be no problems. Everything is a-okay. Anyway, Shinji, I would like you to make dinner. Because you are my bitch. So, bitch, make me some freaking dinner. Oh yes, that's right. I will do it because I am a bitch. And good night. For some reason. When Misato gets all flustered and upset, her clothes start falling off. Well, they get loose at least. Oh, Masato is going to give us lots and lots more service in the next episode. Why do I not believe her? Because we never get service. Oh dear, what is this? Oh, I know, this is where they find Oscar.
Yo, 遅かったな. 今度は外すな. しっかり決めてくれよ.
Shikaji. He said, sorry I took so long. I want to talk to you about something. We don't know where we are. If I had to guess, I would say that he's speaking with someone from the Japanese government. Somewhere. And not in the scene where he gets killed. Spoilers! But, I mean, come on. We're playing a game based on a TV series that's been out for many, many years. Besides, oh, I do believe he just got shot. So, not really spoilers so much as told you so. Anyway, we've played like how many games? How many games have we played where he got shot? Well, a few. Anyway. Oh, she didn't say hello to Oscar, because Oscar fucked off. Now, show me her stats. So, he could get one more secretion, but you know what, I'm not going. No, you know what, I do want to max it out, so I will do one more secretion next week. But I will not be doing any more of this one, because fuck you, I don't want my Shinji to turn into a sexual Tyrannosaurus. I want it to be as sexually repressed as humanly possible. But I want to level up these ones instead. I don't know which one of these is the one that makes him listen to Oscar. But that's the one I want to level up. Could quickly have a look now. Raising Shinji. Shinji Wikipedia. Here we go. Actually, I don't think it's here. Oh no, there it is. Sensitivity is related. Sorry. Wikipedia. Sensitivity is related to getting Shinji to date people. Sensitivity is this one right here. Okay, we don't want that one. I think. Not too sure. In any case, we want morality. Which is this one. What level of that up somehow. Which I wanna say would be done by would be done by the karate. Though I will have to go back and look at the video because I forgot to look at that on the way. Never mind. Okay, well, let's talk about Metal Gear now. So, if you just came here for the Shinji Ikari, you can leave now. Bye. I'm going to be talking about Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. Oh my god, I keep getting the names mixed up. Metal Gear Solid V, The Phantom Pain. A little bit. I won't be doing any spoilers or anything. Don't worry about that. But I just want to talk about what I've been doing with the game so far. Okay. We're gone. Excellent. So, no spoilers, don't worry. But I have 100%ed the game. In order to 100% the game, you need to complete all missions with an S rank, including the bonus missions that change rules up a little bit. You also need to do all of the side ops, which, well, that was one of the first things I did, and that took a long time. You also need to do all of the alternate mission tasks in each of the missions, which was fun, but also took a long time. And last but not least, you need to collect all of the animals, which took quite a long time, but that was one of the first things I actually did. Doing all of this, and possibly something else, I don't know if you needed to do anything else, gets you the 100% moniker on the main screen in the game. That is not actually doing everything there is to do in the game, however. I've got all the trophies, but there was more stuff to do in the game. For example, what I am currently doing right now is trying to get all of the code names, because the code names are not part of that 100%. They are, however, very difficult to get. Most of them require you to do a particular playstyle 3 times in a row, which is difficult when you're trying to do the same playstyle 3 times in a row. It's also really infuriating because you can only get one particular code name at a time. For example, let's say I want to get the code name that is for using pistols. And I use pistols, and I'm really good at the game now, so I stealth it. And I'm using a drag gun, so I don't kill anyone. So I get the Foxhound ranking, which is the best ranking in the game. However, guess what? That doesn't also give you the pistol code name. So, you need to intentionally kill people. Seems fair enough. But that'll give you the Fox code name. So you need to intentionally kill people and intentionally be seen and go into an alert state. So you have to make sure that you do things that negate the other. Basically what I'm saying is, you don't just need to keep in mind what you need to do to get that particular code name. You need to keep in mind what you need to get other code names so that you can purposefully not do them. So that you cannot get those code names in favor of the one that you actually want. And to make matters worse, as I said before, you have to do this 3 times in a row. So if you make a mistake at some point, then screwed up, you have to do it another 3 times. That being said, it's not really that difficult. The hardest one I had to do so far was Eagle, which is the headshot one. I don't know why it was so hard to do, mainly because it kept, like, triggering other particular codenames, like all pistols or something. But anyway, I decided that it was one of the first ones that I wanted to do, and then I realized, you know what, I should just do the weapon, like, all pistol one, all assault rifle one, all shotgun one, while doing all headshots, well, except for the shotgun, of course. You can still do it with the shotgun, but I'd actually gotten it by the time it came time to do the shotgun. And then, hopefully, naturally, it will trigger itself, which it did, which I was very happy about. The more difficult ones that I have done, actually, wait, have I done that one yet? No, you haven't done that one yet. But one of the more difficult ones was doing, of course, again, 3 missions in a row, mainly using placed weapons to take out targets. That kind of sucked. It involved me trying to sneak up on people, putting C4 on their back, and then running away and blowing up. But I did it! Next, I do believe I have 3 more codenames to get. Orca, which is for throwing weapons, which I've been doing a good job, but I've been doing too good a job because I've been using smoke grenades and they just give me the freaking foxhound thing, so I need to do grenades and get into alert states. Anyway, I'll get it, don't worry. Also, I need to do tortoise, which is killing people or like defeating enemies and doing missions while using vehicles, which I've never really been a fan of doing. So that'll be fun, because I'll just roll in a tank and just mush it down. I also need to do this, the third one that I need to do is related to a buddy. That buddy is D-Horse. The other ones are fairly self-explanatory, you know, DD just make him kill people or stun people, you know, Quiet, make her kill people, the other one, the robot, you know, just kill things with the robot. But D-Horse is quite different, because you need to take out soldiers using D-Horse. And I don't know if you noticed, but D-Horse doesn't have that many weapon appendages. Case in point, she has none, is she? What you need to do is trample dudes, but you need to trample the majority of the people that you take out. Luckily, there is a particular mission that you can do where there's only one real soldier you have to deal with, so you just trample him, grab the target, get out of there. However, I'm also doing all of the missions in order. Because, you know, why not? Because I finished the game, that unlocks you to play the game with your creator character avatar, which is kind of cool. So I want to do all the cutscenes with my Leo lookalike. Although he doesn't really look like me because he's got short hair and the beard's not quite white. But you know, I can close my eyes and squint. And it's Leo. It's got my name. It's good enough. So I'm doing that. Forget what mission I'm up to. But, well, I'm further along in that, in doing this, that I started literally this morning, than I am in the entire playthrough that I've done so far on YouTube. Yes, I believe we literally just made it to Africa. And I'm well into Africa now. Yes, indeed I am. Anyway. So I'm going to keep doing that. I don't really know what I'm going to do when I finish that though, because I've played pretty much everything there is to do with the game. There was one thing I really wanted to do. I've actually also developed every single item in the game. That isn't those bullshit online only resource ones that cost a bunch of resources and take forever to freaking research. I'm gonna work my way through them, but it's gonna take up some time. I also need to level up my my teams more in order to get them, because some of them require 120 level. In like something, I think it was base building, which is my highest like team, but still, shit. Anyway, one thing I wanted to do now that I've unlocked all the weapons is I wanted to do missions with each and every weapon, and I had actually started doing that. Unfortunately, I did it in a slightly flawed fashion. I went through all the pistols first, in order. And then, and then I did the submachine guns. Well, actually, I'm doing pistols and submachine guns at the same time. Except there was one slight problem, in that I did all of the one-star pistols, and then all of the two-star pistols, and all of the three-star pistols. So I'm kind of doubling up on a bunch of weapons. So I've done a whole bunch of pistol gameplay, and not much of anything else. But there's a bazillion and one weapons of the game. I don't really know if I really want to play the game enough to do at least one mission for every single weapon in the game, just so I can try it out for one mission. But, hey, I'm happy because I've actually got an incentive to kill people now, which is something that was lacking until this point. I never ever had a reason to kill people, because you might as well just trank them, because they might be good dudes for your mother base. But now that I'm doing these code names, well, you pretty much need to kill them. Well, you don't need to, but you need to take out soldiers. And, you know, do that with a... Well, you could... You could knock them out, but What's the fucking point? That being said, I just got the throwable weapons left, well, and the vehicle, and one more, and then I'm done. So, that's not really gonna last much longer. Also, for the, what are they called? The challenges? That was unlocked with a patch, I think it was 1.06 patch. I've pretty much done everything. I've pretty much done all of those challenges. The only ones left are, of course, gathering code names. I think at the moment I need to get 90%, but I'm sure another one will trigger for 100%. What else do I have to do? I have to do 50 online FOB defenses, which I believe will be the last one. I'm currently at 41 successful defenses. So I'm getting there. And what's the other one that I have to do? Oh! 10 online dispatch missions, which is really interesting, because I could have sworn I've already done that many, but I don't do online missions that much. But I did do a bunch of ones for fuel, even though I hate doing them because it means a whole bunch of people will die, but I desperately need fuel at this point because I'm trying to build up my third FOB. Oh, that's right, I don't have FOBs in my YouTube playthrough yet. Well, I've got three of them now, and I'm trying to max out the platforms on all of them, on the third one. And then I'm slowly collecting more Mother Base coins to get my fourth one. I have not spent a single dime on this game as far as Mother Base coins are concerned, or insurance is concerned, but I use the insurance, the one free insurance you get, and I've been just collecting daily, you know, things that give you, you know, quite enough Mother Base coins to get yourself extra FOBs. So, if that's something that was, like, you thought kind of disgusting, it's really not that bad. You get plenty of, like, Mother Base coins in the game, so don't worry about it too much. That being said, to get, like, enough levels to get those friggin' online-only development weapons and items, I'm pretty sure I need at least two more FOBs, because I've got three FOBs at the moment, with almost, well, they've all got at least A++ soldiers, and almost most of them are S or S++, and I'm still really, really far away from being a high enough level to unlock those things. Anyway, it's a great game, and I love playing it. And I do kind of want to play Yakuza 5. I haven't bought that game yet. I will. But honestly, at this point, we've got 1 month until we're going to start playing Persona 4 and recording it. So that's going to take up a lot of time. So I'm probably not going to play Yakuza 5 for a long time. Oh well. Let's play some more Metal Gear. Oh, on that note, about Metal Gear Solid The Phantom Pain being my Skyrim 2.0. I think my playtime now is at about 550 hours, which is still like half, like literally half of my playtime in Skyrim, on my main character at least. But, you know what, I don't think we're going to get 1,000 hours out of The Phantom Pain, but it is definitely a contender. It is definitely up there with the likes of Skyrim, as far as a game that just makes me want to play it and nothing else. Because I just, every time I'm like, yeah, you know, I've done everything, let's play something, you know, let's play some more Metal Gear Solid Phantom Pain, because it's such a good freaking game. Also, it's a good game to, like, I now sit and watch YouTube at the same time as playing it. I haven't had a really good game to be able to do that in a long time. Oh no! Oh dear! My projector disappeared there for a little bit. Oh, that was my third strike today! Oh dear, I guess I'd better go. Well, cheerio, chaps. I don't know why I'm speaking. That was English. What are you doing? Anyway, I'm gonna stop speaking in a French accent now. And my throat's starting to hurt, so I should probably stop doing this. I have to work tomorrow. But for now, my name is Leo, and I will see you next time.